Hello Bishes, welcome back to my channel. So I'm finally back from Santa Fe, and for any of you wondering, last week I was in Santa Fe, New Mexico, and I went to Meow Wolf and had a lot of fun where I answered all of your questions while in another state traveling. So I hope to be able to do a video like that again in the future, but also check out this very cute plushie I got from Meow Wolf. I had to get one because I could not resist. But anyway, on to more serious matters. Today, I just wanted to kind of keep a chill video where I talk about what I do throughout my day as an artist working in animation. And I say artist in animation because in the animation industry, you're not always going to be the same title. Like, I've been a storyboard revisionist, storyboard artist slash writer, and then most recently, an assistant episodic director. This video will basically summarize what a basic day in my life it's pretty much like working from home, since we are still pretty much working from home in the animation industry. Some studios have already adopted a hybrid way of working where they'll go to the studio someday and then work from home other days. But for me so far, I have just been working from home the past 2-ish years now. Anyway, so usually when you work in the entertainment industry, a lot of people tend to start late, but I will say I usually start around 9 a.m. just because you're still kind of in control of your schedule. You still have flexibility to let your producer know like what times you're willing to work from and until. So for me, usually I will say it's from 9 to 6. For some other people, it's more like 10 to 7 or 11 to 8. That's not really my cup of tea. But anyway, so normally around 6 a.m., that's when I wake up. I will work on stuff pretty much before I get ready to do anything because I feel like I always need this 1 hour to just get something done, to get the energy ball rolling, and normally this will be my own personal project. It could either be for my graphic novel, it could be for my Instagram comic, or it could be editing for a YouTube video. Whichever one is more of the priority in that moment is usually the one that I will be taking care of. And after that 1 hour passes, I'll go down and, you know, make some coffee, make some breakfast, and feed my cats. And this is normally around 7 a.m. to 8 a.m. or so. So once it hits 8 a.m., that's when I will do stuff like wash my face, brush my teeth, get ready. So then once I'm done with my whole morning routine, that's when I actually sit down at my desk and start getting ready for work in terms of whoever is employing me at that moment to do stuff for them. So when I sit down and get ready to work, I normally pull up all the materials I need for whatever assignment or things I have to do. My most recent position was an assistant episodic director, and a lot of this usually required me to pull up scripts or look at fixes that need to be done, and these are usually in the forms of Excel documents or Word documents or PDFs where I have to read stuff so that I either know what the new updated script is or I get a little bit of a refresher of what are the fixes needed to be done on this shot. And what I have to do is I will start storyboarding either from scratch if there are new scenes added, or if it's like adjusting an old board that needs updates, I either look at the script and see what the new changes are, and I will just plug in drawings so that the new storyboard matches the new script. And if there are fixes that need to be done, like, oh, something is wrong with this shot or this scene, then I will go in and I will erase the drawings and replace them with the correct poses, the correct expressions, whatever it is that needed to be adjusted, I will adjust. So this is normally around 9 a.m. to 12 p.m. I'll spend a 3 solid hours just getting stuff done. I feel like these first 3 hours of the morning are the most productive hours for me personally. So anyway, after I get done with those first 3 hours of just work, I usually don't really have meetings in the mornings based on my previous experiences. I usually tend to get meetings more in the afternoons because probably in the morning it's more about like the production teams and edit teams getting their updates for each other, while as the later afternoon is more of like reserved for the artists. So at 12 p.m., that's normally when I'll go down and eat lunch, and it's a mini break for me. I'll like put on a video, just play with my cats, or just do something to take a break while I eat. And after I eat lunch, I will also go out for like a 10 to 15 minute walk. Sometimes it is after lunch. Sometimes it's at 2 or 3 p.m. in the day, but I just try to make it a point to get out and breathe some fresh air at least for 15 minutes of the day. So I will go out and just take a walk, listen to music, or just think about something. So after lunch is over and I take my 1 hour break, it's about 1 p.m. now, and that's when I normally get back to work and do stuff as per usual. So I'm either picking up the work that I left off in the morning before lunch, or I will just be getting onto a different assignment. It's always going to change every day because that's just what it's like working in the entertainment industry. But because this chunk of the day, which I will say is like usually 1 to 4 p.m. or so, I will normally save this time to do work that is easier. So in the morning, I take care of the more important fixes or the more important priority stuff. And then in the afternoon, I kind of save it for the lighter work because I know my brain is going to be a little bit lazier during this time of the day. So I will save the easier stuff for me to do so that I still get stuff done and it's not so much of a struggle. And of course, in between, don't forget to take breaks and drink water and like get a snack or something. Sometimes I'll just play with my cats and spend 15 minutes putting on a video while I'll play with my cats so that they also get some attention. So then by the time it's 4 p.m., this is when I usually for some reason tend to get more meetings, probably because you allow board artists and stuff to get the most they can out of the day. But in addition to that, I also work with a lot of storyboard artists from around the world in different countries and different time zones. So I feel like 4 p.m. was always just that sweet spot of a time where, you know, for the most part, other people are awake. So that's when we'll have meetings and pitches. And usually in meetings, it's either your whole team just regrouping and you're just updating each other on stuff, or you'll have pitches where you show everybody your latest work and you get everybody's feedback and input and you know what to do as your next steps for the next day or the next week. And then once in a while, you'll also get one of those meetings where you guys just talk about absolutely nothing and you start asking each other fun questions just for fun. So then once it hits 6 p.m., that's like the end of the workday. And you know, setting your boundaries is very important when you're working from home, because I feel like that was the struggle at first from working from home. It's nice to be at home and be with your family, your pets, your kids, or whatever. But you also forget that, oh, like I don't physically walk out of a studio. I don't have to drive home to really establish the fact that I'm leaving my workplace. So you kind of have to do something physical to mark the end of your day, or just find a way to set that boundary between you and the end of the workday. And for me, it's literally just like go down and eat dinner. So I kind of spend that time just prepping my dinner and just making my food so that, you know, it's my transition back into my personal life. After I eat my dinner, I just go work out. And the reason why I tend to work out more in the evening is because I feel like I'm more motivated to exercise when I have enough content that happened throughout the day that could have been like stressful things that, you know, made me feel a certain type of way, and I just want to get it out of my system. And if I save my workout for the nighttime, I feel like it gives me that chance to get my mood back to normal before I, you know, decompress and go to bed. And what I notice is that every time after I'm done working out, I just feel so much better than that clouded, groggy feeling that I had after I just finished the workday. So then after I finish working out, I will go start my night routine. I'll go shower, wash my face, feed my cats, and then pretty much just take a moment to just relax. I don't know, sometimes I'll do a face massage or a face exercise or just do something nice for yourself for just 5 minutes, you know? But before I completely go to bed, I spend another hour again of my day, like between 8 to 9 or sometimes 8 to 10 p.m. or so, just either working again on a project of mine, whether if it's just a YouTube video, an Instagram comic, or my graphic novel. I'm not completing like some major portion of the project I'm working on. It's more of like I'm just taking another baby step, just chipping away at this bigger project by doing a little small thing every day. But of course, you don't have to feel pressure to do this every single day if you going through the workday was already enough for you. And sometimes I just don't do anything if I did feel like the workday was too much for me. So yeah, after I finish spending that 1 to 2 hours on my personal project, that's when I'll just decompress and I'll just sit in bed and let my mind just do whatever the fuck it wants. Like before I go to bed, I want to give myself that freedom to let my brain go wherever it wants to. I just pretty much leave it open to myself to do whatever I want and I go to sleep. So that's pretty much a day in my life as an artist in animation working from home. I'm pretty sure a lot of other people have a routine either very similar to this or even very different from this. I know that the whole stay at home order is a lot lighter than it was before, so some people might even go out and do something. But I feel like for me, I'm just personally, once I spend the day at work talking to a lot of people, I'm done. I don't want to talk to anyone anymore and I just want to be by myself. I feel like a lot of you can probably relate to that, but you know, you do what you need to do to get through the day, and I hope that, you know, if you are working from home, whether if it's an animation or something else, maybe this video was of interest to you or sparked some inspiration somehow. But yeah, I just know that this is a question that actually gets asked a lot whenever I do these student talks, and there are a lot of students who actually wonder what an actual day-to-day of someone working in animation looks like. Like, what does it look like from 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. And that's just what it looks like for me. So anyway, thank you for watching this video, and I will see you all in the next one. So peace out and stay wholesome, bitches.